Hi, today we are going to uncover the secrets of the humble magnetron. One of the applications for a magnetron is something you already know about, a microwave. I think now we're ready to cut this thing up like a Christmas ham and see what it's really made of. Okay, this is very important. You see this pink band here? This is a ceramic insulator that is oftentimes made out of beryllium oxide, which is extremely dangerous. If it's broken and you get particulates either in your mouth or in your lungs, you could potentially develop a condition called berylliosis, which will have both acute and chronic side effects that'll probably end up killing you. Oh, and it's also carcinogenic. In fact, magnetrons are full of bad news, so I can't stress enough to wear some proper protection while you work. Okay, it's a little while later and I've made some progress. So I've removed some of the outer case of the magnetron. Let's see what some of these parts are. Oh, well, this one that just fell off. This is just a brass reflector. It prevents waves from bouncing back into the magnetron. It's not really important. So here beneath the antenna and beneath the cover, we can take a look at one of these permanent magnets. There are two of them, once again to make a magnetic field going through the cavity of the magnetron, which you can see in there is the cylinder. This surrounding it are the heat sinks, because this magnetron, while it's in operation, gets very, very hot. In fact, if you look inside of a microwave oven, this is what the fan is pointing at across here. Now in the back, first of all, we can see more pink danger, so I'll cover that up right as soon as I can. And we also see these two coils here. Alright, let's see if I can get off one of these permanent magnets. So with everything else gone, I'm just left now with the resonant cavity of the magnetron. It's sort of unbelievable that beyond all the bells and whistles, a microwave oven can just be boiled down to this. I think I'll bisect it right across here so that I can get a cross-sectional view of this inside pattern. Alright, well, we see that the inside is made out of copper, which is not what I was expecting. I thought it would be made out of, steel, which would be a much tougher material. This actually wasn't too bad to cut through. Here, that center rod right there, that's the filament where the electrons are ejected from. That's superheated, by the way, so that the electrons can migrate away from it into the cavity. Now, I depicted it in the schematic as circles, but in this magnetron, these triangular regions, trapezoidal regions, these are the resonant cavities for the electrons. Now I know that they've been trying to make magnetrons a lot cheaper over the last decade or two. I never imagined they would simplify it down so much. The other one looks pretty much the same. Once again, we got that filament action going through there, and this leads up to the antenna. Well, there we have it. I think we have fully uncovered what is inside of a magnetron, truly. And this is just your typical magnetron, the kind of thing that you would find in your microwave at home. So I think we answered what we set out to do, and that was, once again, to find exactly what a magnetron does and how it works. Just remember to stay safe and have fun, and as always, thanks for watching.